I'm Elisa Buoso, and in a short presentation, I will talk about IP strategies for banks and fintech companies. First of all, a little agenda is required. And in particular, in this presentation, I will talk about IP strategies, the relevance of IP in the bank sector, the relevance of IP for fintech companies, and finally, I will focus on the future perspective. So, a definition is required. What is strategy? Strategy can be considered as a means by which individuals or organizations achieve their objectives. Currently, strategy has become less related to the time plans and more related to guidelines. Finally, a strategy can be considered as a decision support and as a coordination device. There are two managerial frameworks that can be used in order to create a strategy. These are the resource-based view and the market-based view. According to the market-based view, it is possible to distinguish five forces that determine the competitive intensity in a market and, therefore, the attractive on an interest in terms of profitability. The forces are the bargaining power of customers, the bargaining power of suppliers, the threats of new entrants, the threats of substitute products, and a competitive rivalry within an industry. On the other hand, resource-based view consider a company as a bundle of resources. And these resources have to be valuable, rare, imperfectly imitable, and unsubstitutable. If we look at banks, we notice that traditionally banks have been characterized by a static business model for years. And in this static business model, trade secrets played a crucial part. Then, in the recent year, the important of IP and in particular of patents has been taken into account. And there are two reasons for this change. The first of all is a new case law, and in particular the so-called State Street Bank case that held that anything that to provide a useful, concrete, and tangible resource can be patented. Therefore, business processes can be considered patentable as well, but under certain conditions. The second reason is the increase in the use of technology by financial institutions. Now, the current strategy considers patent in order to protect valuable innovation and to capture the value of their investments. If we take fintech companies into account, we can see three strategies: blocking strategy, leveraging strategy, and defensive strategy. It is interesting that companies tend to use more than one strategy, and no strategy is dominating blockchain. Moreover, the choice of the strategies is connected with the dimension of the company. If we look at the past, we can see that every bank transaction was issued to a bank-owned and bank-related channel. Today, non-bank channels play a crucial role, and this is the change. The change, in other words, is related to the importance of non-bank channels. And as a consequence, we can predict that in the future and within a decade, non-bank channels will dominate the revenue.